Students, a very good morning to all of you. In our last class, I shared the text of the poem, The Dramatic Monologue, Pyrrha's Lover by Robert Browning. In today's class, we are going to critically analyze and do the textual analysis of this great dramatic monologue by Robert Browning. As we know, Robert Browning is a very famous 19th century British poet who was the son of a clerk in the Bank of England, who was a very highly gifted intellectual man of fine character. Robert Browning grew up in a comparatively rural parish. His mother was a Scotch. Till the age of 14, he remained at a school for young gentlemen run by a Mr. Reddy at Peckham, after which he was placed under the care of a private tutor. At the age of 17, Robert Browning was sent for a term to a Greek class at University College, Gower Street. The systematic use of his father's academic library was probably the most important factor in the poet's early education. While still a boy, Robert Browning had read great Elizabethans and Byron with a special delight. In the year 1834, Browning visited Russia, riding some 1500 miles during the tour. And here he met, and during his visit to Italy in the year 1838, he visited Venice and fell in love with Elizabeth Barrett, whom he married in the year 1846. Mrs. Browning was 6 years older than her husband. The period following his marriage was the happiest and the most fruitful from the point of view of poetry in Browning's life. So, today's dramatic monologue, Pyrrha's Lover, it was first included in the collection entitled Dramatic Lyrics that was published in 1842. So let us come to the text. The rain set early in tonight, the sullen wind was soon awake. It tore the elm tops down the spite and did its worst to vex the lake. So, on a stormy midnight, a man finds the woman whom he loves. He watches her coming to him. This man, this lover, was never sure of her love for him. So, the night is stormy, the wind is strong, wind is blowing. The beloved comes in this state of storm. She kneels down and makes a pleasant blaze. I listened with heart fit to break when glided in Pyrrha. Straight she shut the cold out and the storm. So a storm is there, the night is stormy, the beloved comes to meet her lover, and the lover with a pounding heart listens to the footsteps made by Pyrrha. Pyrrha enters, she shuts the door. Now the storm has been shut out, the night is cold, and kneeled and made the cheerless grate blaze up and all the cottage warm. She kneels down, and blazes up the hearth that is burning there. Which done, she rose and from her form withdrew the dripping cloak and shawl, and laid her soiled gloves by, untied her hat, and let the damp hair fall. And last she sat down by my side and called me. So she enters, her cloak is dripping due to rain. She lets down her damp hair fall. Porphyria sits beside her lover, speaks to him. She talks to him. Browning says, and laid her soiled gloves by, untied her hat, and let the damp hair fall, and last she sat down by my side and called me. When no voice replied, she put my arm about her waist and made her smooth white shoulder bare and all her yellow hair displaced. So the lady enters, she takes off her dripping gown, she sits beside her lover, her hair too are dripping, her gloves are wet. Now she unties her hat and let the damp hair fall beside her. She sits beside him and she calls him, but the lover didn't reply. Now she put my arm about her waist and made her smooth white shoulder bare and all her yellow hair displaced, and stooping made my cheek lie there and spread over all her yellow hair. Now the girl, the lady, sits beside him. She spreads her hair over this yellow hair that now have been let loose. She goes near to her lover and she puts her arm around her lover's waist. She touches that man and spreads all her yellow hair over her shoulders. And murmuring how she loved me, she too weak for all her heart's endeavor to set its struggling passion free from pride and vanier ties, deserve and give herself to me forever. He knows at last that she loves him and he is in a state of ecstasy. She declares that she is in love with that man and he is elated, he is happy. In a murmuring sound, she declares that she loved him. And there has been a struggle in his heart to tell this feeling to this man. She has struggled a lot. In past, she had a sense of pride, but now that pride is gone and she has totally surrendered herself before her lover. And she gives herself to him. She surrenders before the passion. From here, students there is a twist in the poem. Till now, we have read that on the stormy, windy night, Porphyria arrives to meet her lover. Till then, the lover wasn't confirmed about Porphyria's feelings towards him. But now the lady comes. She is all wet. She sits beside him. She proclaims her love towards this man, and this man is in a state of extreme joy. He is elated. He is extremely happy. So, this much for today, students. We will continue this dramatic monologue in our next class. Thank you very much.